Body bags will horror lies.
Hey guys, Rob from Georgia here with you. It is week 319 already. Man, time is just flying. We are officially and finally in the month of October. Man, what a hot summer it's been. In fact, just now the temperatures here in Georgia are just starting to come down a little bit, if you consider mid-80s low. But anyways, so here we are, week 319. And continuing with my theme of my love for Italian cinema, I thought it would be pretty cool to revisit some Itai. But look at a film that just is new to me as far as Itai goes. And that is, of course, from 1984, his film Rats, Night of Terror. And what a cool title that is. We are talking Bruno Itai, and we're talking 88 films release. What a great release this is. Not as fully loaded as I would hope it would be, but what an absolutely beautiful slip in. Of course, what a nice print to be framed. And, you know, there's a few extras in here, but I just want to take a second and read to you the back. I don't do this often, but I think this is worth, in light of what many think of Itai. On the back here of this 88 release, we have this. It took some time for Fright fans to really groove to the eclectic, insane, and often inane brilliance of the late Bruno Itai. Now belatedly viewed as a master of cut-price plasma spillage, the time is ripe to revisit one of the great man's wildest accomplishments, Rats, Night of Terror, unveiled to audiences of video violence in 1984. This post-apocalyptic pot boiler sees some of the last humans alive grappling with a horde of flesh-eating rodents and a shocking final revelation that has fast become Itai's signature twist, also featuring a superlative ensemble cast that includes such Italian gore legends as, you ready for this, Ottaviano Della Croce. I do believe I got that right. He plays Kurt, by the way, and if you did not know that name, and you ought to if you're a lover of Italian cinema, he plays probably, I don't know, maybe the greatest zombie to ever don the screen. We're talking Lucio Fulci's zombie, of course, Wormface, or whatever title you want to give to him. But he's the lead role in this, which is really awesome. You get Greta as Chocolate. Yeah, seems a little politically incorrect for our day and age. But of course, we all know her from Demons. Masamo Yuani, I think he was in Zombie 3, maybe, if I'm right, and Gianni Franco. That's just a small part of the cast, but they're all very, very, very familiar to Italian horror. Now, really, I sort of implied the plot already just by what I read, but you do have some survivors post-apocalyptic world. It's an apocalyptic world, right, or film. 100 years post-nuclear war, some survivors are just kind of making their way, get held up in some sort of installation, and they're under siege by rats all night long. There's some revelations given throughout the film, and in the end, perhaps, and I don't know, this surely has been said multiple times, but I haven't heard anyone say this, and I'm a big, you know, I love researching films and stuff, but I do believe the end is a bit of a tipping the hat to the 1968 film Planet of the Apes and the great revelation at the end of that film. Perhaps, it's just me going off on a little bit of a limb. But yeah, Rats. So, you know, Bruno Itai, I got, you know, really, I was probably immersed or introduced to Itai when I was a kid in Hell of the Living Dead. I didn't know what Italian cinema, I mean, I was just being sort of grafted in at an early age. I mean, with the likes of Dario Argento and Fulci. Of course, there will be others, Michele Sauvay, right? Hell of the Living Dead, you know, as a kid, I have such fond memories of that film. Now, upon revisiting it, it's it's a little, it doesn't quite match up to my memories as a kid. But still, this is a movie that, you know, I mean, there's some things working under the surface here, but this is a movie that you just need to have fun with. I mean, you just need to, it's the end of the day, it's perhaps getting late, and you don't have to get up so early in the morning. Perhaps you just need a mind break. You know, throw in Rats, Night of Terror, some Bruno Mattei, and enjoy, you know, sort of a, you know, a heading cast of, you know, the greatness that was Italian, you know, movie splatter, horror cinema. I mean, you know, especially getting this, you know, getting to see Ottaviano, you know, in a lead role without all the word, you know, mud and all that makeup stuff, everything they used to bring him to life in Zombie. You can actually see him act, for what it's worth. I mean, it's not, you know, it's not Oscar-winning performances, but it is a fun, and the special effects being practical, hands-on. You know, I'll tell you what, I mean, there's a few involving sort of the rolling wave effect of the rats coming in. And, you know, I was thinking to myself, and I was revisiting it the other night, I was thinking to myself, really, you know, come on, what's worse? Some of the most horrific CGI that we have to endure, or some hands-on practical effects that, quite frankly, you know, are lots left to be desired. But you know what, at least it's handcrafted, at least there's some love poured into it, and even if it doesn't quite convey the horror or suspense or whatnot that it's supposed to, you can have fun with it. You can know that people, real people, were in there, you know, with their hands crafting it, you know? Whether how well it looks on film or not, I mean, it's not to be laughed at. It's to be enjoyed, I think, and have fun with it. I mean, too often we just don't have fun with film anymore, I don't think, at least in the way we ought to. Rats, you know, I thought it was, you know, it's one of those movies that does grow on you a little bit. The first time I watched it, I was like, okay. And then the second and third, by the fourth, you know, I was like, you know, I'm starting to kind of groove, you know, get a kick out of certain aspects of it. And so I am so thankful for the 88 release of this film, and for the wonderful print. Anytime we can sort of, you know, increase our horror vibe right and throughout our room and area is it's not a bad thing. Yeah. Some Bruno Mattei, you know, he's definitely worth enjoying. Doesn't quite, you know, rise to the level of Lucio Fulci and some of his greatest moments in cinematic history, but I don't know if that's really, if Mattei even really cares, right? I think he's just there to be enjoyed. So it's an apocalyptic film, some survivors under siege from rats all night long, and let it work on you. Sometimes we need to allow our imagination to kind of run away from ourselves, even when we're watching cinema. And the end is quite disturbing. I mean, if you just allow it to. I mean, I think too often we might see something and we just might chuckle at it or laugh or throw up our hands and wonder, how did we even get to this point? But that's the whole point with Italian cinema. I mean, you want to sit there and kind of like, you know, or you're just going to simply enjoy. And so for week 319, I bring you Bruno Mattei's Rats, Night of Terror, 1984. Same year, of course, Wes Craven's Nightmare on Elm Street will dawn the screen, which I saw as a kid at 14. But I was unaware of this little Italian gem that was out there. But now I do. And so also Claudio Fragasso, Zombie 4 fame, of course, cinematographer, who also did La Casa 3. Of course, we know that is Ghost House, right? So really, it is a great homage to Italian cinema, horror cinema, in probably more ways than many have probably given attention to. So if you've never seen it, or you're region-free, or you live over in Europe and it doesn't really matter, the 88 release is great. Plus, if it's still included, you get this awesome print, right? So enjoy the rest of your week. Enjoy the rest of the reviews this week as we sort of creep up to what will be a Halloween-themed theme week here at Body Bags. And just enjoy the ride of October. It can only get better with day after day after day, right? So enjoy October. Enjoy our month. This is our month. Enjoy Body Bags and all of our reviewers. And kick back and just enjoy what is one of the greatest months of the calendar year. And before we know it, dare I say, it will be gone. So enjoy it. This is Rob from Georgia here with you with another, hopefully, good review. We always end these things off with, go Bills.